Hi, my name is Ryan Heffner, and in this video, we will demonstrate evaporator process isothermality using an Equilibar back pressure regulator to control saturation pressure. Precise saturation pressure control is key to evaporator efficiency, and the unique design of the Equilibar regulator offers several key advantages that make it an excellent choice in this application, such as instantaneous pressure adjustment to changes in upstream conditions, precise pressure control, regulating multi-phase flow with blockage-resistant designs, and minimal valve authority. Some of these advantages would also comply to condenser design. Let's go take a look and see what's happening. Here's our evaporator unit with CO2 process fluid on the left and water alcohol mixture on the right. Our system starts with CO2 process fluid feeding the evaporator through this needle valve. CO2 enters at the bottom and exits at the top on the left side. The water alcohol heat load fluid is pumped into the evaporator through this flow meter, which reads in gallons a minute. Transducers at the inlet and outlet of the evaporator process measure temperature and pressure. The temperature of the water alcohol mixture is also measured at the inlet and outlet of the evaporator here. Here we have the Equilibar dome-loaded back pressure regulator, which will control the saturation pressure of the CO2 in the evaporator, providing isothermality. The Equilibar is controlled by a QB pilot regulator, which is in the back, and will control the supply of nitrogen to the dome of the Equilibar. Let's go run the system and see what happens.
As the needle valve is opened, CO2 flows into the system, and the heat exchange process in the evaporator begins. The heat load in this run is set to 0.2 GPM. The overlay shows two graphics. On the left are temperature plots and bar graphs showing the inlet and outlet temperatures of the water, which is our heat load, and the CO2 process fluid. Green represents CO2 temperature, and blue represents the heat load temperature. The light blue line on the temperature plot represents the CO2 inlet temperature, whereas the red line represents the heat load outlet temperature. The graphic on the right is a representation of the pressure versus enthalpy curve for CO2. The light red line represents the saturated vapor line, and the solid orange line indicates evaporator pressure, which is controlled by the Equilibar. The vertical blue dashed line represents the pressure drop across the Equilibar. As the heat exchange process proceeds, the enthalpy of the CO2 drops at the inlet of the Equilibar, moving the blue dashed line left. At this enthalpy state, deposition occurs, forming dry ice at the outlet of the Equilibar. This is visible in the zoomed image at the left of the screen. I will run the process again, but this time the heat load flow rate will be doubled to 0.4 GPM to show how the Equilibar can maintain pressure control with varying heat loads. It is expected during this run that the convergence time will take a little bit longer to reach equilibrium. This convergence time could be used to back calculate the heat transfer rate. To reiterate, the light blue line is the CO2 inlet temperature, and the red line is the heat load outlet temperature. As the heat transfer process reduces heat load outlet temperature, convergence of these two lines will conclude isothermality. Equilibar's blockage-resistant regulator design prevents the solid particles from plugging and allows them to exit without disturbing the pressure control. We can see this on the left side of the screen.
Thank you for watching this video. To summarize, we demonstrated evaporator process isothermality between the inlet and outlet evaporator process ports. We achieved that using the Equilibar back pressure regulator to control saturation pressure of the process. We demonstrated that the Equilibar regulator can handle multi-phase flow without disruption. Something that we did not get a chance to show you in this video is that our valve can stably operate with 1 psi dp or less, which minimizes system pressure loss and provides better system efficiency than traditional valves. For more information about the Equilibar back pressure regulator design and how it can be used in your vapor compression cycle system, or any other process for that matter, please contact us using the link in the description down below.